Hey, what's up everybody, Jimmy the Gamer here, and welcome back to another video of Tom Clancy's The Division on my channel. And in today's video, finally, I got the fucking Skull Gloves, so I can make a high-end build. Used to run Striker, but the only thing that I found bad about Striker, I know it's like the most DPS slash damage output build, but the more you hit, the more, you know, you get damage, and if you miss shots, you will get reduced damage, and with Skull Gloves, you will always have, you know, just like that 16% buff. So if you go 1v1 against the Striker build and you keep moving and maybe hip firing, you know, you will have an advantage because he can't, you know, keep his shots. So I'm gonna go through my weapons, the talents, my gear, and the mods. This is a two-piece electronics and four-piece of firearms. Well, three pieces of firearms, and the holsters, you know, just auto rolls. But I'm gonna go through what you need in this build. First of all, I'm using an LVUIC. You can use an MP7 or MP5, but as you can see, 17.4%. 17.4k base damage is way too low for me, and even though I don't have, you know, SMG damage, but it will get to like 18 point something. But I'm using an LVOIC because I really like this one, you know, 22.2k damage, and with normalization in PvP goes in last stand, it goes higher. So LVOIC best talents for PvP are competent, responsive, and forgiving. And the second one is the Showstopper with responsive. Believe me, the Showstopper is actually super good. Also, you can use this one, an AK-74. I know what you might be saying, like, what the hell an AK? But it's actually super, super good in PvP and PvE. It's like a shredder in PvP and PvE, so you really need to try this. Responsive, competent, and forgiving, you know, the same thing. But maybe in PvE, you might, you know, need to change the talents. But I'm actually not running Barretts for the first time because I have a good heal, so I'm running Vigorous so I can get that overheal from like team, like ally healers and shit. And what you need is health and skill haste. You need skill haste, okay, for this build to work with that much electronics. You need skill haste, and the mods are one firearms mod with skill power and electronics mod with 3% skill haste. Okay, yeah, this build is about stacking skill haste, and you're gonna see why. You're gonna see the times that I have on the pulse and the booster shot. And the backpack is also specialized health, so ammo capacity, and always skill haste. The performance mod are first aid self heal. The skull gloves, yeah, the base damage is very, very low, but in normalization it doesn't matter. Assault rifle damage, crit hit damage, and skill haste. You need that skill haste. I know crit hit chance might be good, but I'm telling you, skill haste is way better. And I got a Pharah's mask. Some people might say Tenacious, even though I do have a God roll Tenacious mask, but I run with Pharah. The amount of Seeker mines, you know, in the meta right now, the airburst one, it can actually get you on fire. So you know, Pharah's mask is a really, really good counter, so you can shoot while on fire if you didn't go by, you know, one shot Seeker build. The knee pads, nothing too much here. You need the short bow championship knee pads. I don't have them, so I just go like with the best one that I have. And the holster is nimble with skill haste, you know, again, stack skill haste. We're gonna go through the mods. The mods on this one is actually stamina. I'm running, what you're gonna need to run one stamina mod with health, you know, to get over that 300k toughness. Plus you're gonna need to unlock responsive. That's why you're gonna need more than 28,000 stamina. And this one is, I think, yeah, same thing, electronics with health. Maybe if you have like you could go like skill haste over here, but I really like having like that 300k toughness, you know, so I like that. My secondary is actually a double barrel shotgun with pedigree. Yeah, when you kill a player, it really, really helps. regenerate your health. You can use one with sustain too, but I'm using this one with predatory. I don't know, I might change it for sustain too, but I don't know, I'll try them both. I do play with both of them, and I think this is like this all for the build. One thing to note, this is what I mod. I don't mod for headshot damage anymore. I just go for crit hit damage, and you can see why. Crit hit damage, headshot damage, crit chance, you know, in normalization, you know, everything's gonna be god rolled. Same thing here, the SR7 suppressor with crit hit damage and enabled grip with crit hit with stability. You could go small grip, but I couldn't control the LVOIC with a small grip, so I went with this one. And my camo is the Grunge Rogue, I think. Yep. The Grunge Rogue you get from level 20 or 20 something in Last Stand. And this one has crit hit chance. You could go crit hit damage, but you know, I just go for crit hit chance and crit hit damage over here. And this one is easily, you know, controllable, so you can put a small grip over here, no problem. And what do we need to talk about more? Yeah, the fucking talent. So that's why I like the skill highest build. So pulse, you're gonna need to run recon pack, because if you take a look at this, even though it gives you 25% crit damage, it has 30 seconds on the cooldown. This one gives you 19 on crit chance and crit damage, but it's 29 on the cooldown. This one, you know, it has 22 and everything, 22 crit chance, 22 crit damage, and 22 seconds on cooldown. And this one has 19 okay chance. So if you want to go for a crit chance, this is the better one. And the booster shot is 29. And you might say, well, I don't care, you know, having like 30 seconds in the cooldown is good. But you know, I use these talents to proc competent and add more damage to my weapon. So don't think of it just straight as a fucking, you know, for the talent, you know, think for, you know, proc incompetent and, you know, maybe other talents that you have. And I run the tactical link. The talents are combat medic, critical save, one is none and on the move, you know, same, the usual stuff. If you have maybe, you know, better talent combination, I know you should run tactical advanced, because I am running nimble, so tactical advance would be good, but I don't know, just like the other ones. And the skin is the Inferno Blaze, the one that I have, you get from a heroic dragon's nest. If you go to the stats, weapon damage 20, crit chance 0, with the freaking Lavoa, for some reason it says 0, but if you count, we have 2 on here, 2 here, 2.5, 2.5, that's 5, with 3, so that's 8.5, sorry. And yeah. But the crit damage is 40%, 40% with, you know, adding that pulse, it goes way higher. Headshot damage is 26, and if we go through the showstopper, crit chance 6% and 63 crit damage and 66 headshot damage. So if you go to, like, if you want to see like what's the outfit that I'm running, a Banshee scarf, a LMB shirt from one of the incursions, I think it's Warringate, and you know, some like regular jean pants and sheriff shoes. So that's all that I'm running. You can, you know, maybe inspect the whole outfit. This is the outfit right here. It looks badass, thank you, I know. But besides that, I'm gonna be showing more PvP videos, and maybe even with this video, I don't know if I drag it too long, but I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and peace out. So if you want to take a look, this is what the build looks like in normalization, you know. 23k damage, you know, the skull gloves go all the way up, so this is what it goes to. This is the cooldowns, 21 and 28. And let's go do some PvP. That's definitely not the right thing to do. I hate the fact that that turret can actually see you doing this. Is it really? Are you for real? Afraid that the other guy will pop up here behind me. Man, if it's not another player, it's just NPCs. Man, just stop. I had to. That's where, like, a legit I had to use the super. Let's just hope that guy is way too far to shoot me. There you go. Are we gonna move into the lead maybe? Oh, we are actually leading. See you, bitch. See ya. I'm gone. I'm straight gone. Oh, that's another player. Dude, I don't have any heals. I knew that. If I didn't have, if I only had like some medkits, maybe it would be better. This guy killed you, Chance, and you, Chance, killed the other guy. How did he do it? Nobody knows. This is the guy that just killed me. You're gonna get the payback. You're a sniper build, right? Great, got sniped. I like this now, bitch. Dude, that guy's a fucking glass cannon. Oh, it was because of booster shot. I'm killing it, I'm actually getting killed. I'm not really killing it. Oh, there you go, buddy spawn is engaged. See, most of the time when you go for like when you go for their spawn point, it really helps. Harper is in a little bit of a trouble. There's two of us. Oopsie. No, that was too long, bro. I saw him using that recovery link. Getting freaking shocked left, right, and center. Is this guy a player or what? Oh, it is. Oh, B3 was actually hostile, didn't even know. B1 is, yo, you're a sniper. You should do your work. Guy an enemy player or what? Oh, friendly fortification. Oh, so that means they're taking alpha. Yup. Don't worry, we're coming for it. Yeah, we won. That's it. We won. You. Scoreboard. Yep. Top of the scoreboard as always. I can't even talk because I burned my mouth. Getting some French fries and they were too hot and I didn't know that. And 13 kills, a streak of 10. No, it's decent. Decent, decent. So if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to drop a like, subscribe to the channel for more Division content, and maybe other games. I don't know yet. Maybe Battlefield 1. I think I'm gonna start doing videos for that game. But besides that, peace out everybody. Jimmy.